Hi everyone. In this session, let me introduce you to the term known as fast users through a simple block diagram explaining the concepts, the selection of transducer, and finally the classification of transducer. Basically, a transducer consists of two main components. They are the sensing element and the transduction element. Sensing element senses the physical quantity or its rate of change. The transduction element converts the non-electrical signal into its proportional electrical signal. In most of the cases, the physical quantity we are supposed to measure is a non-electrical signal, and hence such non-electrical signal have to be converted into an electrical signal, and this is performed by the transduction element. So the physical quantity is first sensed by the sensing element and later converted into an electrical signal by the transducing element. There are cases where the transduction element performs both the function of the transduction and the sensing elements. The best example for such a transducer is thermocouple. A thermocouple is used to generate a voltage corresponding to the heat that is generated at the junction of two dissimilar metals. By definition, a transducer is a device that is used to convert a physical quantity into its corresponding electrical signal. In most of the cases, like I have mentioned earlier, the input signal might not be an electrical signal, which we call it as a non-electrical signal. This has to be converted into its corresponding electrical signal so that we could measure them using electrical methods. The selection of transducer is based on the physical quantity we are about to measure, based on the principle and the order of accuracy. And the classification is based on the application, the method of converting a non-electrical signal into electrical signal, based on the output that my transducer is supposed to produce, based on the electrical phenomenon or the parameter that might be changing during the whole process, or based on the type of the transducer, which is active or passive. Most of us are familiar with active elements and passive elements. Active elements are those which are capable of producing power on its own, whereas passive elements consume power. Likewise, active transducers are self-generating type, where they produce power on their own and they do not require any external source of power. These transducers develop electrical parameters that is voltage or current, which is proportionate to the quantity which is supposed to be measured. Active transducers are classified as photovoltaic, thermoelectric, piezoelectric, and electromagnetic based on the principle of operation. Passive transducers, taking the form of passive elements, do not generate any electrical signal by themselves. They just produce a change in electrical parameter that could be either resistance, inductance, or capacitance. They do not generate power, and hence they have to be powered by an external source of power, and hence they are known as externally power driven transducers. The broad classification of passive transducers is as shown here in the screen diagram. Here, either the resistance, inductance, or the capacitance is varied, and the rest of the classification is shown here. Now I move on to the next kind, where The transducers are classified based on the transduction principle. Based on the transduction principle, they are classified as capacitive, electromagnetic, inductive, piezoelectric, photovoltaic, and photoconductive. Analog transducers convert any input quantity into an analog output. Analog output is one which is a continuous function of time. An example for analog transducers are stain gauge, LVDT, thermocouple, or thermistors. Digital transducers are going to produce a digital output. Digital output are in the form of pulses, which forms a unique code, and the different digital transducers will be explained a little later. Now we are going to classify transducers as primary and secondary transducers. So primary transducer is going to sense the input immediately as an electrical signal, whereas secondary transducer first converts it into a mechanical signal and then into an electrical.